Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 2304. Can you filter to the top five? Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, I've been hearing that the new dynamic arrays have been making it out through Office 365. It's now out to the monthly channel, and which means a lot more people are getting access to it. And one of the people in my seminar, Rick, was happy to have the new functions and said, "All right, I'm trying to do something particular here. Can I use the filter function, but to do a top five filter?" I said, "Huh, that's interesting. Yeah, I've never thought about that." I guess the first step here is to figure out what the largest value is. Not the largest value, that would be easy, that would be max. But if we want to find the fifth largest value in the data set, so equal large of the data, comma five will give us the fifth largest value. And then we could use that as the criteria for the include argument of the filter. So filter all the data in A2 to D43. We only want where D2 to D43 is greater than or equal to this helper cell up here. And that seems to work, gives us the top five. Now, if you don't want to do it in two formulas, you can just wrap the, or put the large function right inside. You know, and so many times I get a question from someone and I send the answer out and they're like, "Oh, no, that's not exactly what I want to do. It's more complicated than that. I want to filter to the east region first and then find the top five just from the east." All right, so here's where we enter which region we're looking for. And then the first question is, what is the fifth largest value in the east? So check out this little formula here. We say if B2 to B43, if the regions are equal to the selected region, then give me the value from D2 to D43. Otherwise, give me a zero. Send that whole thing into the large function, and again, ask for the fifth. So that gives us 8219. For the whole data set, 8569 was the fifth largest value, but for the east region, it's 8219. You'll see here if we change this to central, 6167, or west, 6141. So that's updating on the fly. And then to do two conditions inside the filter, and I'm pretty sure I've covered this before, you put each condition in parentheses and multiply them together. So we need a true times true for that to be true, and we get our top five. Beautiful, right? Again, to do that without the helper cell, the formula starts to get a little bit ugly, a little bit hard to understand. If D2 to D43 is greater than or equal to the large of the if, and then multiply that by B2 to B43 equal to the region. That's all great. All right, and a couple of weeks went by and everyone was happy. But then we came up with a situation where there's a tie. What if there's a tie for fifth place? So our formula is saying, basically we want everything above 8219, so I faked the data here. I went down here and took the sixth largest item and made it be 8219. So I thought I was asking for the top five, but in fact I'm getting six. All right, so what if we want to resolve this and really only return five? So the beautiful thing about Excel, even with these dynamic arrays, is there's multiple ways to solve every problem. I said, all right, let's do this. First step, let's find just the east region record. So that's simple enough. Filter A2 to D43, and then the include is where the region is equal to the selected region, like that. Okay, then I said, all right, now that we have just the east region records, let's take that formula and sort it. So the sort, I want to sort the filter. Which column do I want to sort by? I want to sort by the fourth column, and which order, descending, so minus one, and that's going to give me just the east region, but this time sorted high to low. All right, now here's an awesome little trick. When dynamic arrays came out, what was it, about four or five months ago, Joe McDade on the Excel team said, "Oh, you'll never have to press Ctrl+Shift+Enter again." Not so fast there, Joe. Ctrl+Shift+Enter still has a use. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this formula to the clipboard, Ctrl+C, get rid of the formula, and if I want to limit these results to just five rows, I'm going to select the five rows and the four columns like that, type the formula, paste it in there, and then press Ctrl+Shift+Enter. And that will force them to only give me five results like that. All right, so this is great, great news that the dynamic arrays have made it out to the monthly channel. The last hurdle, of course, is the semi-annual channel, and that'll happen later this year in 2020. I know a lot of you already downloaded the book, Excel Dynamic Arrays. I've updated that book now. We've kind of reached general availability, the second edition, and it's not free anymore. $3. Click that eye in the top right-hand corner. Hey, if you like the tips in this video, please subscribe and ring that bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments in the comments section below. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.